Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. If you're trying to find the fuel filter and replace it on Hyundai Elantra, this video should be very, very helpful guys. Please subscribe and let's grow the channel together guys. Thank you for all the support. So, if you're looking how to find and replace the fuel filter on a Elantra 2011 to 2016 model guys, we'll show you how to do that. So, we had some water in the gas and we wanted to replace the fuel filter. You can check the video out and what the symptoms are. So we removed the engine cover. We follow the fuel rail, fuel line right here, and it just goes under the vehicle, guys. So obviously fuel filter wasn't in the engine bay. Next thing that we did is we went under the vehicle, okay? And usually it will be on the frame somewhere, but our leg, no there at all. So stay with us to see where Hyundai decided to hide their filter now. First thing that you need to do, you will need to disconnect the battery. Do that guys at least 30 minutes before you do the fuel pump replacement. That way you don't have any charge in the system. Okay, you don't want to have any sparks. Do that away from your house. Have a fire extinguisher available because at any time something might go wrong. Most likely it won't, but it happens. We've seen things go wrong before. You need to get some gloves, guys. Face mask, you want to get some too. You don't want to breathe the gas. Do that in the open. And you want to have eye protection as well, because it might spray some fuel. Okay, and we'll show you why the fuel pump, the fuel system is usually under pressure. Get some shop towel as well. We'll need a big screwdriver now and a hammer. So in order to remove the seat, guys, now, okay, first thing that we'll need to do, okay, right here, okay, you get your hand, and right here, let me show you exactly where it is, you need to find them, okay, there is right here, in the middle, okay, check out where it is, in the middle of the seat, there is a bolt with a 12 millimeter socket, you need extension as well, okay. We're almost there, and it's pointing that way, up a little bit. Okay, so we need to get it loose, okay, that's good. And now you can grab the extension and the socket, okay, hold the bolt with your hand, and you can pull it out. This is the bolt, guys. Okay, there is one more, identical to this one, on this side, right in the middle of the seat, okay. And it will take you some time, but you'll be able to see it. Perfect. Okay, you can grab the bolt and later you can start them by hand and just get them tight. When you install the seat, don't forget these bolts. Now, on the front right here, okay, there is two clips, one on this side, one on the other. So you need to grab the seat, push towards the back, okay, and pull up. Okay, and you need to get it with two hands. I cannot do it with one. Okay, like that. It's really, really strong. Now you need to get the seat belts out of the way. Okay, and you can pull the rear seat out of there now. It's loose. So this cover now on the newer vehicles, they just use silicone to glue it together. Some of the older ones will have like 4, 5, 6, 10 millimeter bolts. Which is a better design if you ask me than just that silicone glue right here, but you gotta make sure, okay, that you install some fresh silicone when you do that sealant. Okay, and you can see, okay, where the fuel pump is located now. Okay, right there. Okay, we have the wires now, so we need to disconnect the wires. Okay, and on this one you pull up on the thing, okay. You pull up and you release it. Now, this wire, you push in there. Push in. Okay, let me show you. Push this thing and pull it out. Okay, now stay with us to see what else we need to do. Okay, next right here. This is, guys, the fuel line. Right here, the black and blue thing. Okay, let me show you quick. And you need to put some towels here because it will leak some fuel. That system is under pressure usually. Unless your pump doesn't work at all, then you won't have pressure. You need to make sure you have eye protection. It might spray fuel in your eyes. So what you need to do now, you need to click on the blue thing down, okay, and pull it out. But let me show you what else it might happen. So you need to support with your finger on the bottom, push towards the front, push on the bluting, and then pull towards the back. Okay, make sure that, okay, some fuel will come out, I guarantee you that. Okay, we didn't have so much because our fuel pump is shot, so that's a good thing. And on this one, we press on both sides in and pull it out, and be careful not to break it. Okay, just make sure that everything slides out easy. Again, be careful not to spray fuel or anything, guys, because you're working with fuel. So you have to be very, very patient. You have to have fire extinguisher again with you. Okay, and this is the cap here that holds the fuel pump in place. Okay, and that metal ring that holds the fuel pump, this one is recommended to replace it with every fuel pump replacement. And we need to go counterclockwise to get it loose. Okay, this one came loose pretty easy. Some will be really stuck, I guarantee you that. Okay, and this one will not be able to come out. It will come out with the fuel pump. We'll have to lift it up a little bit. And then just lift up the pump a little bit. We'll be able to eventually get the ring out of there. Okay, like that. So that's a fuel pump. Okay, oh, it got stuck on this side now. Okay, like that. Okay, next we have the fuel lines. You have to pull the pump up a little bit and just remove the fuel lines out of the way. Okay, like that. And then the fuel pump will get stuck. And that's normal. You have to help it a little bit with the screwdriver, guys, because it's the tightest fit I've seen on any vehicle, this one right here. Okay, and then we have the floaty thing that measures the fuel tank, and you need to have a bucket ready. Okay, and you have to immediately put the pump in the bucket because you'll spill some gas. Okay, if you spill any in the car, clean it immediately and shampoo the carpet. We have the procedure how to do that on our channel. You can see it's almost full tank of gas right now. Okay guys, so now we are ready to get to the fuel pump filter. Okay, this is it, guys, right here. This is the fuel pump filter inside the fuel pump assembly. We need to push that wire down. Okay, so there is one tooth that you need to press it down, okay, and pull the wire out. Next, we'll need to, okay, those goes to the inside. Look at that now. You need to push it, okay, push it in. Okay, let me just grab with two hands quick. You need to push the white thing in, and then those, okay, black teeth, you need to push them towards each other, like that. Okay, and you can carefully, very carefully, okay, pry with the screwdriver, but careful not to break anything, guys. Careful not to sprain your eyes. Okay, that O-ring, now we need to have one more O-ring, and it's inside. Okay, right there. So you need the O-rings. Most likely you need to replace them with new ones every time you do a fuel filter replacement. Now this is the fuel filter right there. Now you need to turn it clockwise, okay, and it will come loose. Okay, and you can pull it out. Now if it doesn't want to come out, you can take the pump apart, but careful with the wires. Okay, you can pull up on those pieces, okay, but you won't even have to do that. And this is, guys, the fuel filter right here. We have a secondary fuel filter that's located underneath the fuel pump, but that's more like a mesh thing, so it doesn't catch big things, but it catches actually the big things, but this thing is for fine material. Okay, that's what it's filtering. So this is the filter right here, guys. When you get the new one, all we have to do, push it in, all the way in, turn it counterclockwise, install the hoses, put everything together. And that will be the whole video, guys. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe and see you guys next time.